third subdivision of the women's qualification. And four teams involved, in USA, Great Britain, Canada and France. And eight teams out of the 12 contesting will go through to the team final. I'm very much looking forward to seeing how the USA and Great Britain perform. Great Britain in front of their home audience, USA, genuine chance for gold in the women's team event. As the officials, judges make their way into the arena and to the various apparatus that they'll be observing. Seven-time Olympic medalist Shannon Miller is alongside me. And Shannon, you know this USA team inside out, but they're going to have some great competition today from the Canadians, the French, and British as well.
That's right. This is going to be an exciting competition. USA did a tremendous job during the podium training. That's the training before the competition starts and the only time the athletes are allowed on the Olympic podium prior to competition. They did a great job there. They just need to see it through to competition. The name of the game for Team USA is hitting their skills.
How much are they concentrated solely on making a team effort and getting through to the team final and doing well there, and how much will their minds be on other finals?
Well, I think luckily in gymnastics, when you focus your goals on just getting the highest possible score you can on each event, you're doing yourself a favor, you're also doing your team a favor. And I think first and foremost for Team USA and really all of the teams here, it's all about the team in this qualification round. It's great if you make it into an all-around final, an event final, that's icing on the cake. You want to get that team gold medal.
We've been here a few sessions now, men's qualifying, the women's is already well underway, and a fantastic crowd in for this session in particular with Great Britain performing. And the athletes are about to enter the arena. Huge roar for Team GB, and they are off to perhaps the toughest of the four apparatus for the women. The beam, France on floor, United States vault, and uneven bars for Canada. I wonder how they'd feel about starting on beam.
Starting on beam is always nerve-wracking. Of course, on the men's side, they started on pommel horse, akin to starting on the balance beam. Did a great job, so hopefully they can follow suit.
Perhaps the best place for the beam is somewhere in the middle of your subdivision, so that it's not first, there's not the pressure of it being last, it's not exactly buried, but in a less pressurized situation.
I tell you what, I think so. Starting on bars is absolutely terrific.
I think this is going to be one noisy session, and it's going to be a lot of fun. I hope that for their sake, that Imogen Cairns, Jennifer Pinches, Hannah Whelan, Rebecca Tunney and Beth Tweddle can channel the enthusiasm and support that's here into good performances.
Certainly, and there is opportunity for medals, for even gold on this British team. Beth Tweddle is absolutely incredible to watch, particularly on the uneven bars. We'll be watching her closely on that event.
So the athletes well into their warm-up for their first performances. And there is the US team and Jordan Weber, one of the several standouts.
Certainly, she is the number one girl headed into this competition. Jordan won the world championship all around at last year's Tokyo Worlds, but she's got some stiff competition.
Canadian team, hoping to get through to the last eight for the team final. Italy looked well placed to go through. They had a very good session. And here is the Great Britain team. Young Rebecca Tunney, looking forward to seeing her perform. And the great experience of Beth Tweddle anchoring the side. But Imogen Cairns had a lot of injuries, but back at her best now. And here is the French lineup. Nina Dufournet, a wonderful gymnast. And the French with a great tradition of creativity and flair. And the French will have the opportunity to show that on floor first up. A couple of the stars here, Jordan Weaver and Beth Tweddle.
Always exciting at the start of competition. The butterflies are going. Just want to get it underway. Get that first event underneath you. Calm those nerves down a bit.
Raisman has been performing at this top level for a while. Medalist at World Championships in floor, part of the winning team from Tokyo.
Raisman is super strong. A lot of times she goes right under the radar, but she is extremely powerful, has really been a rock for Team USA. This is going to be a big vault. Yurchenko, 2.5 twist, lands and hop on the landing. That is a statement. This is a big event. Vault is going to be a huge deciding factor between gold and silver for these teams, particularly Russia and the United States.
What a confidence boost when your first gymnast goes up and performs well. I think this could be our session. And Raisman, just that little hop on landing.
Just that little hop, a little bit of form breaks in the air, but that is a big vault, 6.5 in start value.
Canada's Victoria Moores is up on uneven bars.
Made her senior debut this year.
She won't be 16 until November.
The floor is really her area of expertise. Just wanting to make it through on all four of these events. We're going to see some high-flying action here tonight on this this piece of apparatus, very nice dismount.
And not one we see too often. She trains at Dynamo Gymnastics in Cambridge, and the gym's owned by her mum and dad. 15.8 for Raisman on the vault. Ideal start for the USA.
And what we'll see from the US on vault, three vaulters with the exact same vault. It's called an Aminar Yurchenko with 2.5 twists. Gabby Douglas has come such a long way in this past year. Round off, big explosion. Another solid vault, just that minor hop on the landing.
They look so confident and so well prepared, Shannon.
They have been training for this day, just as all of these athletes have been. Gabby, as I've said, she's come a long way. She gained so much confidence competing at the Worlds last year in Tokyo. Winning that gold medal with the team, comes around, sees that landing, has that minor step, and she is right near the center line. Good place to be.
Vault, the quickest of the four apparatus. They'll be through fairly quickly, and gives them extra time, I suppose, to prepare for what comes next and take any advantage when it's offered. Douglas of 15.9.
And that's what you hope. You hope the scores continue to go up with each competitor. Jordan Weaver going to be throwing the exact same vault. And we'll see a fourth vault for from Michaela Maroney.
2011 all-around champion.
What I love about Jordan is she is just so rock steady. A little bit of a split as she gets onto the vaulting table, and I believe she hit that red area. That's going to be a deduction. The athlete needs to stay within those two boundary lines. You don't want to get off onto the red, and she definitely makes it there, 3/10 of a deduction, so won't be quite as high of a score.
Well, just watching the replay of her on the runway, she was angling towards that side. She just got off the straight on the runway.
You have to have that specific direction. The judges are watching every move you make. But certainly putting up three solid scores. And of course, during this qualification round, 5 athletes on a team. 4 athletes will compete, and 3 scores will count.
15.833. And their final gymnast and vaulter, Michaela Maroney.
Michaela, the best vaulter in the world. She is world champion on this event. And you'd like to say, go ahead and hand her the gold medal. Pretty much everyone around the world can see the exceptional talent that she has on this event. She's head and tails above everyone, but you have to hit it on game day. She has been calm and cool under pressure, dealing with an issue, a broken toe. Huge vault, and this is her only issue, is she has too much power. She's gotten into a habit of taking that large step forward.
Well, the distance in the post flight, the power you talk about, is absolutely evident. She just took off.
She is so explosive, and she has done this vault for so many years. It's absolutely nothing to her. Look how sky high she is.
She's through it too early.
She could probably throw another half twist in there and be just fine. Absolutely incredible vault. Jaws just drop when you see her.
And of course, she'll do 2 vaults.
She will do 2 vaults. She is trying to make it into the final round. Judges will average the vaults, these 2 scores, to see where she places. Top 8 make it to the finals. And her second vault is every bit as fabulous as the first.
A little taller than many gymnasts at 160 centimeters or 5'3". Certainly accentuates the elegant lines.
Great gymnast Arthur Akopian, who is her coach and incredible technician.
Just going to go across to beam. See how the British team is going. Hannah Whelan.
Bronze on this event at the 2012 European Championships. Aerial back layout, and she just places it off. Very difficult series, going from a sideways move to backward. We have seen a lot of rough issues on balance beam today.
Hannah, 9th all around at last year's World Championships.
Stepping into that dismount, double pike a little bit low on the landing. Judges watching the hip height. Your hips are dipping below your knees. That's going to be a big deduction.
Well, this session, Shannon, definitely a lot noisier than previous ones.
We've got the hometown crowd and the hometown girls. And unfortunately, with that fall, placed right off the beam. So easy to have a break in concentration. Maybe just a little bit jittery getting this first event underway. Beautiful position. And pulls around this double pike. Take strong legs once you're squatting that deep. Great job saving it.
Look at the second vault for Michaela Moroni. Nope. We won't. Anyway, she combined score in the vault of 15.8. It's more than a whole mark better than the next best in terms of those gymnasts seeking a place in the vault final. So Moroni stamps a class on that apparatus.
It is just incredible to watch. I think she's just been doing these vaults for so long. They're just very easy for her, and she is now done with her competition. That's all she needed to perform. Athletes working on getting the perfect tape job for each event.
All carrying little strains and minor injuries. And you're saying that they prepare themselves for each apparatus with different strapping depending on where the strain is going to be.
That's right. You're going to prepare a little bit differently for your ankles on floor versus uneven bars. And sometimes you just get used to the tape job and how you have practiced your routines, and you don't want to change anything once you get to competition.
Across the floor, and from France, Sophia Cesari.
She has had to sit out a couple of pre-Olympic competitions, but is here competing for France and has said this will be her swan song, her final competition, so I'm sure she's going to lay it all on the line. Said floor is such a wonderful place for the athlete to be able to show their personality, and we'll see the difference between those that are very comfortable performing in front of the audience, making eye contact, playing up to the crowd, and those that are just getting by. Of course, that will be reflected in the score as well. Finishing up that standard double pike. It looks like her heel might have just gone out of bounds.
Didn't see the flag raised, so she may have got away with that.
Line judges in charge of watching each of those corners. They'll throw a flag. 1 foot out of bounds, 1/10, 2 feet equals 3/10 of a deduction. Very nice tuck double, just a little bit over. This is a great view of this bounding pass. You have to be so technically on to make sure that you're in the right position for the second move. And here's where we think she might have stepped out of bounds. Oh, looks like her heel stayed up. I would give her that and say no deduction.
Yeah, I think she was clean there, so well done to Seri. Hannah Whelan, 13.066 on the beam. Well, Great Britain have got the tough one out of the way, but they had a problem or two. On they march to their second apparatus, and massive scores accumulated by this Gun USA team on vault. But that's where the good marks are to be had. You have to vault well to get them. Now, an even bars routine of Brittany Rogers of Canada.
Very nice swing. Watching for some incredible release moves, and as always, looking for those handstands. The judges wanting to see all of those pirouettes perfectly vertical, or at least within 10 degrees. Big swing, half double front, and lands a very good bar routine.
And a 14-5. That's a good effort there. And Brittany Rogers, it's actually the top score so far on uneven bars. Once more, the gymnasts into the warm-up for their next apparatus. So it'll be underway in a minute or two. So the USA, after one rotation, well, they're really benefiting from good performances on the high-scoring vault. It's after one rotation, comparatively.
And as we always try to mention, vault is such a high-scoring event. You really can't compare those vault scores directly with floor scores or beam scores.
And this is where France, United States, Canada, and Great Britain will be for their second rotation. For Cesari on floor. Yes, USA on uneven bars, and it's Canada on beam. Just a warm-up vault. Don't get too excited, folks.
On the floor, representing Great Britain, Jennifer Hitchens.
Sophia Cesari of France is going to be first up on vault for the French.
The French have been plagued by injuries, but always smiling and optimistic. Yurchenko, 1.5 twists. A little bit deep on that landing, but nice vault. Puts it right in the center of the mat. Pretty good height and distance.
Sophia trains out of Dijon in France.
Good block off the horse. Nice form in the air, comes down to that landing. Straight on line.
I think the positions of 6, 7, 8, and 9 in the team competition are going to be very keenly fought. And pressure on these gymnasts not to make a mistake to hold up their team. 14-1-3-3. Cesari. Aurelie Melosena. Born in Grasse, but living in Rouen.
And she is an absolute leader for this team. Motivated and strong. Front layout with a half out. Again, very well done, but as you mentioned, when you're on the bubble, when you're looking for that eighth place position to get in the team finals, you can't make any mistakes on the errors, the small areas.
Jordan Weber. Uneven bars.
Weber is certainly a terrific all-around gymnast, but if she has a weakness, it is on this event. She has had issues she's had to fight back from. Nice full pirouette right here. You could see that lower back arch. She tends to have something of an issue in each bar routine. Very nice to Tkachev. Full twisting double layout, sticks the landing.
And emphasizes that she did. Well, there was a problem mid-routine at the arched back.
And you hate to say you're used to making a mistake or having an issue during the fall during the routine, but I think she just is, and she's used to fighting her way back. She is so strong. Kind of muscles through, which is tough to do on uneven bars. Pulls it out with a beautiful full twisting double layout. Very good line in the air, looks for that floor, and knows she needs to stick it.
Well, Brittany Rogers of Canada set a high mark on uneven bars. There's the mark in for Molasena on vault. Rogers was 14-5, but 14-8-3-3 for Jordan Weber, and she's the new leader on uneven bars.
And that was a pretty good set for Jordan. She's coming up on two of her best events, balance beam and floor.
Remarkable to think that uneven bars is not her strongest, and yet she still had a fourth placing at Worlds.
It is pretty amazing. Kyla Ross, this is her event. This is a huge reason why she is on the U.S. team for this bar score. The U.S. team a bit weak in this area. And Kyla has shown herself to be very consistent. Taps that bar, that's going to be a slight deduction. Beautiful release. She has great lines. And terrific composure for such a young athlete. Just a senior this year. Double layout dismount, she sticks it every time.
Well, the Americans doing a great job with their dismounts. 15-year-old Kyla Ross joins the party, if you like. And Martha Caroli is one of her coaches.
Martha Caroli, she is the women's team coordinator, so not the personal coach of any of the athletes. She heads up the overall program and, of course, has been part of USA Gymnastics for years and has done a tremendous job choosing this team. And they have done incredible in the squad leading up to the games. Really focusing on finishing these pirouettes as close to handstand as possible. Judges will take it from the time her second hand hits the bar. and a gorgeous double layout, and she sticks this every single. I'm not sure I've seen her take a step ever.
Carla was born in Honolulu, and a 14.866, and she's slipped past Jordan Weaver. My goodness, they're posting some scores, Shannon.
They are, and if you think that was big, Gabby Douglas can throw a score in. She is tremendous on this event. Just watch for these release moves. They are absolutely sky high. We're watching from a terrific spot to see this young lady. It's 10 feet above the bar. Beautiful full turn on one arm. Huge. She has so much hang time up there. She has plenty of time to see the bar to grasp it. Just beautiful. Made the bar finals last year at World Championships, but has a new, even more difficult routine. Double layout dismount, and that's the way it's done.
Well, stunning performances from the US on uneven bars. They just stick these landings, give such a good impression of control and execution.
It's certainly the number one team coming in, but you always have to hit on game day. They're doing well so far. Got the balance beam coming up. Hannah, terrific on this event. Bronze again at the 2012 Euros, as well as balance beam. Whip to triple. Great way to start the routine. You can hear the audience behind her. There is nothing like performing at the Olympic Games on home soil. Double tuck. Great cover. Kind of dances out of it. This is when you need the crowd. Last tumbling pass. Double pike. Beautiful job.
Well, they loved it. She hopes the judges did too. Second Olympics for Hannah Whelan. And just turned 20.
Absolutely incredible. Whip. Three twists in the air. Made sure she completed it all the way around. And of course, these dance moves just as important as the tumbling. We've seen this last pass quite a bit, the double pike. Athletes no longer allowed to lunge. They must stick the landing, just like in the men's competition.
Top mark on the floor so far belongs to Vanessa Ferrari, 14.9. And 13.933 for Hannah Whelan. So it won't be a place in apparatus final for her.
No finals, but that is definitely a strong score and will certainly contribute to the team effort.
Well, a massive favorite with gymnastics fans around the world, and particularly here, Beth Tweddle.
I think having the Olympics here in London went a ways to keep her involved with the sport. Music chosen just for this crowd. Big double Arabian in a pike position. Beth has done so much to make her mark for Team GB and to really put gymnastics into the forefront. Last pass, 2.5 twist, beautiful stag jump out, very controlled.
Oh, didn't she work the crowd? Well, 5 years ago, she thought that London 2012 might be just too far away and she'd be 27 and thought she wouldn't do it. But here she is, and I'm sure she's glad that she stuck with it.
Such an inspiring career, and I have to say, just very tremendous to have an athlete that's so strong on uneven bars and floor exercise. Those are two different skill sets and body strengths. And look at the way she tumbles. Double Arabian piked coming around. Great landing, just a tenth for that step. And finishing up strong with his 2.5 twist, does that nice stag jump immediately after.
So Athens, Beijing, and now London for Beth Tweddle. Will this be a career highlight? Gabby Douglas, 15-3-3-3 on uneven bars. And she goes to the top of the heap with about half a mark to spare. Well, I have to say how impressed we all are with the performances so far from the US. They're living up to their grand reputations.
Well, sometimes it's harder to come in the number one position. Everyone's gunning for you. I think we're going to see some movement, though. Certainly have some great teams coming up in future sessions.
14-4-3-3 from Beth Tweddle on floor. That's the third best of the day.
Strong mark. It would be great to see Beth there in the floor final.
Just Ferrari and Mitchell of Australia ahead of her at the moment. And this was Elsabeth Black of Canada on beam.
Ellie is very strong on floor and vault. Hopefully making the event finals in vault. Nice series.
Nova Scotia's first female Olympic gymnast.
She has increased her difficulty in execution on this event, working hard to be more of an all-around athlete. Beautiful, connected to a back tuck from that switch leap. Double tuck dismount, a little bit short. Pretty good overall routine. Just a few errors here and there. she's coming up on some of her best events.
13.966 on beam for Elsebeth. Well, after two rotations, even allowing for the fact that the US has been on the high scoring vault, it's a significant lead compared to other teams after two apparatus. And now they're preparing for their third. Great Britain to the vault, France uneven bars, US the beam, and Canada the floor.
Gymnast, the warm-up is over. Prepare for competition.
Not too many hold-ups in this subdivision so far. Maybe I shouldn't speak too soon, but it's moving along quite quickly, or at least it feels it does, because of the performances we're seeing, Shannon.
Halfway down already, we haven't had a lot of those judging holds that we've seen in other subdivisions. Kyla Ross on balance beam took a fairly nasty fall during the podium training. We call it split the beam. It doesn't sound fun, and it isn't, but got back up like a champ. She's doing fine. Beautiful series, and Kyla has just been so impressive with how consistent she has been throughout the entire Olympic qualification process in the U.S. She's only 15 years old, will be 16 this year, yet she has certainly plenty of international experience. Although I think when you get to the Olympic Games, it's a whole different ball game.
Two Italian gymnasts are on top at the moment, and beam. And Ferrari and Felito.
Balance beam, a typically strong event for the U.S. They made it through their weakest event, the uneven bars. Double tuck dismount. Very nice. Kyla once again doing her job.
You know, if you were trying to read something into her expression as she got set for the dismount, it was just absolute calmness.
It's a bit eerie how calm these athletes are at such a young age.
Haven't learned the art of self-doubt.
Maybe it's good to be young and simply not know.
Great Britain on vault. And another performance from Hannah Whelan. We're seeing a bit of Hannah through this subdivision.
Double twisting Yurchenko. Fairly high scoring vault. She'll start from a 5.8. And of course, if you're just picking up gymnastics from several years ago, you'll notice quite a bit of difference in the scoring. The difficulty value and the execution right here, round off. Back handspring onto the table, two twists off, just that hop on the landing. Chest maybe a little bit low, only a very slight deduction.
Yes, gone is the perfect 10, and the scoring is much more open-ended, and seeing scores in the 14s and 15s.
That's right. Execution basically comes from a perfect 10, and the difficulty score is added to that.
So the deductions are made from the 10 with the execution. The difficulty is again broken down into several parts. When we've got a spare hour, Shannon, we can take everyone through that. But 14.5 on vault for Hannah Whelan. Imogen Cairns. Oh goodness, here's a gymnast who's had some injuries. It's a great tribute to her that she keeps coming back.
Certainly love of the sport. Yurchenko, 1.5 twist, beautifully performed.
She had 2 years out with foot injuries. That's not including an ankle injury, a broken ankle in 07.
It's incredible what these athletes go through. Once you get to the Olympic Games, it is all worth it. Right here, nice block off the horse. Perfect in the air, legs tight together. Beautiful. Just a tiny, tiny hop on the landing.
And her attitude to those problems she's had, of just that every injury has made her stronger. Kyla Ross, 15.075 on the beam. So she goes to the top of the standings on that apparatus. And Cairns, 14.433.
And over a 9 in execution, which means she had very little execution deduction. Very well done.
Now, Rebecca Tunney.
Rebecca has just been a delight to watch. Yurchenko, double twist. Trying to hold on to that landing. Looks like she may have stepped right onto that red area.
She's only 15, so the baby of the team. She's had a lot of help with her running approach to the vault from a field event coach here that's a friend of mine, John Trower. And she really wasn't a good runner. And that's something that's really been improved in her approach to the vault.
It's a bit interesting because gymnasts really don't run. We have that run down the vault runway, and that's all the running we really do. So a lot of times we kind of have to learn how to run appropriately.
And Tunney was the fourth and final vaulter for Great Britain, so they're done with that apparatus. Still a bit going on though with floor and beam. Jordan Weber. Catch her on beam if the competition allows. Yes, she's ready to go.
And we hear all about the all-around gold that Jordan won at Worlds, but she also picked up a bronze on this event. Beautiful front aerial. One arm back handspring to a layout step out, rock solid. Beautiful tucked full right into a back handspring. Incredibly difficult series. Very nice side semi. Her strong hold on that top spot has been incredibly impressive. Although I think she's going to have a bit of a fight on her hands come all around finals. Nice turn, a little bit short, I think. Two and a half twist. Nice solid beam routine. And that's going to put up another strong score.
Yes, there's just one balance issue towards the end of the routine, but Weber, solid. I think they might have taken some confidence out of the performance of the U.S. men's team, who really, in qualification, surprised and delighted many how they hit all their routines.
And she is going over to talk to her personal coach, John Getter. Not all of the coaches are allowed on the floor at the same time. Of course, that's one of the things you have to get used to during international competition, is your personal coach is not always on the floor with you.
14-4 for Rebecca Tunney with her vault.
It was very interesting in podium training. The gymnasts were rehearsing their lineup and their routines. Coaches were doing the same. Who's going to come in? Who's going to go out? Who's going to fix the board, chalk the bars? Everything was well choreographed.
Yes, if it's not your normal personal coach, you need to have faith in them to be able to put the springboard or set up the equipment just how you like it.
That's right. It's so important that these girls work together throughout the year and with the other coaches so that they do have that faith. Right here, tuck full, incredibly difficult, and moves right into that back handspring step out. Judges looking for no pause during those series.
Green light's been given to Victoria Moores of Canada for her floor routine.
Victoria has finals potential on this event. Probably Canada's best chance for a final right here. Incredible opening pass. Double twisting, double back. Such light music and such powerful tumbling. It's a great mixture. One and a half through a triple. Sometimes these athletes make the twisting look so easy, you second guess whether you saw two or three twists.
Sometimes the judges struggle to get it right too if it happens too quickly.
Two and a half twist. She needs to put up one last great tumbling pass. Make it into that top eight. Double tuck. Just out, it looked like possibly out of bounds.
Oh, I was looking for the flag and didn't see it. It might be another one of those where she kept the heel above the red zone.
And that's as a sign of a well-trained athlete, knowing where the boundaries lines are and keeping out.
14-7 on beam for Jordan River. That's third best of the day. USA 1, 2, and 3 on beam to this point. That's the Great Britain total, 125.498. France, 123.930. And they're off to their fourth and final apparatus. In this third subdivision of five. British crowd probably can't wait to see Beth Tweddle on uneven bars, but this was Gabrielle Douglas on beam.
And Gabby has had a history of struggles on this event. A little bit questionable, pulls through there. One thing that she has gotten so much better at is when she does have a mistake, she regains her concentration. Beautiful tucked full from a standing position. Gabby could certainly be an all-around contender, but she's got to hit this event. Beautiful leap series to a back tuck. Nailing skill after skill. So far, just a wobble. Needs to put this dismount right to her feet. Well done.
Well, she lifted that left foot, but put it straight back down again, and a 15-266. That is top score on beam, ahead of teammates Raisman and Ross. Victoria Moore's 14-1 on floor. That's not going to be good enough to get her into the apparatus final.
And that is too bad. I'd love to see her during the floor finals. There is just a lot of great competition out there today.
United States still significantly, this time over Italy, Australia, Great Britain, Canada, France, and Brazil. But again, until everyone's been through four apparatus, we need to just sit tight.
Got some heavy hitters coming up with Russia, Romania, China.
Great Britain to uneven bars. France the beam. United States the floor. And Canada the vault.
Kyla not originally planning to compete on this event, with Michaela Maroney being out with her toe issue. Kyla was called up, doing a little Phantom of the Opera. Big Arabian double front, a little bit too big. Rebounds right out of the floor exercise area. Tucked full in, and I have heard from some of the athletes that the floor is very springy. They like that. Judges watching these turns, very important to keep that heel up. Good stuck landing, and she's doing a great job for Team USA today. Big double tuck, cut it a little bit short on that block. Very nice overall routine. She's gonna have a couple of deductions with the short landing and out of bounds.
And they do such a great job to concentrate when there's a rousing reception for a British athlete on uneven bars.
Huge. Right here, stag leap and stepped out of bounds. Luckily, she left that right leg hanging back, so she'll only get the deduction for 1 foot out. That'll be 1/10 of a deduction. And it is hard to concentrate at some point, but sometimes you just pretend that crowd roar is for you and it helps you with the adrenaline.
There must have been 2 or 3 seconds there where she would have completely lost the music. The applause was so loud.
And these are things you train for. Muscle memory goes a long way. Do these routines 1,000 times. See, Allie Ray's been there, who has really become the leader for this team. She was named team captain by her teammates.
So Ross, 13.733.
And hopefully a score that they will drop.
Gabby Douglas next. It's interesting that Vanessa Ferrari of Italy, her floor routine score is held up for so long. Let's see if it gets challenged now.
Gabby is brilliant on this event. She's really going to get the crowd behind her. 1.5 to triple full. Beautiful. And this is her time to shine. She loves to play to the audience. Huge double Arabian, and that's going to be a problem. I think the U.S. team is just a little overzealous right now.
Well, it's that well-sprung floor that may be creating a problem or two as well.
And you hate to think you have to tone it down, but you've got to rein it in, keep in bounds. Of course, her nickname is the Flying Squirrel because she does fly not only on uneven bars but here on the floor. Big tuck full in. Incredible height on these skills. Just barely stays in bounds on that last pass.
It's got to be tough for the gymnasts on floor if it's got more life and bounce than they're expecting or than they're used to. Yes, they've had podium training, but to make that subtle adjustment, if that's indeed what might be causing the problem.
It is certainly an adjustment. Definitely would rather have a bouncier floor than what we call a dead floor or one that's not as springy. Saves on the ankles, but you do have to rein it in. You've got to shorten your steps or take a step out to make sure you leave yourself an extra couple of feet at the end of the run. And again, that just comes with experience on being able to tumble on a lot of different floors. Both feet out, 3/10 of a deduction. Luckily, she didn't fall off the floor and slide to her backside. Big tuck double Arabian.
It's got so much height, just like over-rotated it. Across to Great Britain on uneven bars and young Rebecca Tunney.
Nice release. Judges just watching a couple of these little form breaks. A little bit split legs here and there. But she is moving right through this bar routine. You don't want to stay up there too long. It gets very tiring on those hands. Great job.
There's nothing of her. She's so slightly built and yet so strong and yet elegant too.
She is going to have such a long career. It's going to be tremendous to watch her as she grows, but she's already doing a spectacular job for this team. See her stoop through into that half pirouette right here. Great release move. Catches that bar with no problem. A beautiful height. Very small leg split, but you wonder if the judges even see it when they're looking from the side view. And this is a great view overhead to see those transitions from high bar to low and low to high.
Wonderful appetizer for her teammate to come in, Beth Tweddle. He's just a queen of this apparatus.
And I imagine she's been giving some tips and hints to the rest of her teammates on this event.
And 14.825. And Rebecca Tunney, that's her fourth best at the moment. Could make an apparatus final. All right, here's a moment to treasure. First appearance, and we hope it's one of several for Beth Tweddle on uneven bars. Fourth in Beijing.
It's absolutely amazing on this event. Certainly could win a medal here, if not gold. Beautiful, one arm full, right over the bar. Has her own move, the toe on Takachev half. Absolutely stunning, incredible combination. Double, double dismount.
And they just about lift the roof off here at North Greenwich Arena. That was special. Well, doesn't she pack some difficulty into that? The connections and the releases, but scores in for Douglas, 13-7-6-6 on floor. So no final for her.
I tell you what, it brings tears to the eyes to see Beth nail a routine like that. She absolutely deserves it.
Back to the floor, and Jordan Weber. What a treat we're getting here in this subdivision.
You can bet she watched Gabby go out of bounds. Huge opening pass, double-double in a touch position. Again, out of bounds. And as well as Team USA is doing, there is some room for improvement before finals day. Jordan just looks at home every competition, doesn't matter where she's competing. She just has the exact same demeanor. No frills, but no hesitation. Complete confidence in her ability. Terrific competition for Jordan Weber.
Oh, a great routine, and again, she had to deal with the noise of the British crowd going off when they saw the score for Beth Tweddle go up for uneven bars. I'll just tell you that she has smashed the field with that, but didn't bother Jordan Weber.
Right here, out of bounds with that right heel. US has got to rein in that power just a little bit. But Jordan, steady as ever, doing a terrific job. Score for Elizabeth Twiddler, Great Britain on
So Weber needing something in the 14s, mid-14s. But there's another look at Tweddle.
Absolutely incredible. Just smashes the field. More than a 16-0 on this event. And this combination is so difficult, so intricate.
And the 16.133 is 0.8 better than Gabby Douglas, who we thought set a wonderful mark.
That is huge. That is gold medal potential right there.
And certainly helps the Great Britain cause as their total, 170.656. And their work is done for the qualification process. Still another performance to come on floor. Alexandra Raisman. Well, Weber, that's a good score in the mid-14s. That's got her in third place at the moment, so perhaps headed for the floor final.
Ali is one of the strongest tumblers in the entire world. All eyes on her. One and a half to a double Arabian punch layout front. Comes back with a piked double Arabian. Absolutely beautiful. Making use of the entire floor exercise on this dance pass. Triple twist, well done, all the way completed on those turns. Huge rebound out of that move.
Well, will Reisman claim a place in the floor final? Black across on vault. A couple of the Canadians looking for not just one vault but two and a place in the vault final.
This is Ellie's best event, extremely strong. Nice vault. A lot of distance and power. Unfortunately, not going to make the event finals if she only did one vault.
Well, I had an indication she was going to do two, so we'll just stand by for clarification about that, but getting towards the end of the subdivision. It's been most impressive from the USA. Some highlights also from Great Britain, especially Beth Tweddle and young Rebecca Tunney. Alexandra, she's come in with the best score on floor, 15-3-2-5. She's pushed Ferrari and Mitchell back to second and third.
And I think she's in a little bit of disbelief.
13-9-3-3 for that a solitary vault in the end, it was for Black. Canada. Total 167.696. Importantly for them, they're just ahead of the Australians. So Canada sitting fourth, top eight to go through. And the USA, oh, handsomely out in front by some 11 points. But GB in second. Italy third. Then Canada, Australia, France, and Brazil. So Great Britain can be proud of their efforts in this session. Got the team through to the team final. And we'll see what other finals their gymnasts have made. So still quite a lot of women's qualification to come in the fourth and then the fifth subdivisions. Germany, Russia, China, still to come, as well as Japan and Romania. So, a short break. The judges to refresh themselves. The crowd can take some refreshment, and it won't be too long before the fourth subdivision gets underway. two, three, four, five, six, seven. So, India 7, Germany, China, and Russia. Okay. Let's get back in here. Officials are making their way back into the North Greenwich Arena for what will be the fourth subdivision of women's qualifying for the artistic gymnastics. The subdivision is simply just another group of competitors. And this time, in the fourth, we'll have athletes from Germany, Russia, China, and a mixed group from Austria, Colombia, Belarus, Venezuela, and Uzbekistan. It's been a quite sensational day of qualifying for the women. Not least of all because Jordan Weber, the world all-around champion, looks like missing out on a place in the all-around final because two of her teammates have qualified ahead of her, and there's a limit of two per country. A quite astounding outcome. something of a double session, this one, for the spectators. They get to see two subdivisions. They're quite quick in terms of the duration. So Russia filing in. They'll be on floor. Chinese gymnasts will be on beam. Tough apparatus on which to start, but they can handle it. The mixed group will be on vault, and Germany on uneven bars. So there's a graphical confirmation of what we're saying. One way or another, it's been an intriguing day, and there's plenty still to come. We've had stunning performances, we've had some upsets, we've had falls from star performers. So the Chinese team up to greet the judges across on beam. Russian team will start on the floor. And very smart leotards for the German team. Nadine Jarosch, Kim Bui, Elizabeth Seitz, Janine Berger, and Oksana Chuzovitna. A name that feels like it's been around for a very long time. Shannon Miller.
Yes, she has. Absolutely incredible athlete. 37 years old, 6 Olympics. Stunning to watch her still out there competing and winning medals on the world and Olympic level.
Well, we've already seen Yordan Yovchev reach a rings final at the age of 39, so why not? This is the mixed group field, Austria, Colombia, Belarus, Venezuela, and Uzbekistan. The German team there, Chuzovitna, looks like she won't be up on uneven bars, the way the draw appears.
She doesn't typically do the uneven bars as much as she is a power athlete. Very strong on the vault.
Well, the news will have filtered around the other teams about Jordan Weber most probably missing out on a place in the all-around final.
It is absolutely devastating for Jordan due to the two-per-country rule. She is knocked out by both of her teammates, Allie Raisman and Gabby Douglas, for the all-around competition.
She's missed out because the U.S. is so strong. They've had a stunning session.
And you can guess this Russian team has heard the news. I'm sure it did move rapidly through their ranks. Victoria Komova, certainly someone to watch. She is going to give the U.S. a run for their money.
Warm up, but almost over. And the petite Chinese gymnasts almost made for the beam, aren't they?
They really are. They're spectacular on bars and beam. Elaine Mustafina, we see there, coming back from a major injury, an ACL tear.
So it's Mustafina who's going to start us off with this fourth subdivision.
And she is such an impressive athlete to watch. Huge double Arabian right off the bat. Impressive lift, completely vertical, and she definitely has the personality.
Well, we know this floor's got great spring, but the height she generates, spectacular.
See, she is such a solid athlete and was just on top of the world. 2010 world champion, expected to win the Olympics until she tore her ACL last year and put her out of commission for a bit, but she is back looking very good.
Oh, flirting with the edge of the area there.
And she has had quite the growth spurt since 2 years ago. Double tuck. And sometimes that's very difficult to deal with as a gymnast because all of a sudden your balance is thrown off. Your body doesn't quite work the way it used to. You've got to recreate that body awareness. Finishing with a triple twist, a little bent legs in the air.
Alia Mustafina, well, it's great to welcome her back from a serious injury. And we've got some Russian support in the crowd. And they don't look like cheap seats either. It's the mixed group on vault and Jessica Gil Ortiz. Born in Miami.
Front handspring, front pike with a half twist. Very pleased with that vault. Pretty solid. And again, we're looking for the value of these moves. What is the D score? What is the difficulty value? And on vault, it's very easy to follow because it's shown prior to each person's vault.
Had a fifth on vault in the Pan Am Games last year in Mexico.
She gets a good block, up and over, finishes right on that center red line. Perfect place to land. Having a good time. It is the Olympic Games. It's all about enjoying the journey.
And I don't think we yet have a score in for Mustafina. Here's another look at the tumbling pass.
And you just can't count this girl out. Her willpower is absolutely amazing. Beautiful tumbling. Nice way to start off the competition.
And a 14.433. That's about fifth best on the floor today. Could be good enough for a final. Sui Lu of China now on beam.
And this is an incredible event for China. Absolutely beautiful. Reigning world balance beam champion. Beautiful. Pike to a back handspring swing down. Chinese are so elegant, and they treat the balance beam as if it were a sidewalk. Beautiful leaps. Front aerial, back handspring, and that connection to make sure there aren't any serious pauses. And she is moving through so strong, very confident in each move. Double pike. Little stiff-legged on that landing, but just a very tiny deduction.
Up on beam, she did not look like missing an element. She was so confident.
The Chinese really just wrote the book on this event. If you want to see how to perform balance beam, you start looking at videos of the Chinese athletes. You can see those feet just planted on that beam, and here's the dismount. Just stiff-legs it a little bit. Of course, the deduction will just be a tenth for that minor step.
Elisabeth Seitz of Germany getting set for her uneven bars routine.
German champion to start off this event. Full twisting Ginger. Incredible skill. You will not see that very often. Stalled her to a full. Another big release move. Stalled her full to a tucked full in. Beautiful routine. Great start for Germany.
Elisabeth Seitz, originally from the beautiful city of Heidelberg. And a great routine from her on uneven bars. Now, Grishina for the Russian Federation on floor.
Anastasia has definitely some all-around potential. And that surprised many. See if she does it here, a double-double. Two twists, two flips, ran a little bit too far. We've seen a lot of those steps out of bounds. But what impressive skill. This Russian team is looking to put the heat on the U.S. Beautiful dance. Perfect lift on that double tuck. Double pike, pulls that around. Very close to ending off that music.
Yes, I think she finished just half a beat behind the music. We nearly lost Grishina to figure skating. I'm glad she stayed with gymnastics.
We are happy to have her. Double twisting, double back, such a difficult skill, and she makes it look so easy. And we'll watch to see if she received a penalty deduction for ending off the music or overtime.
A tease on vault, 13.533. To catch up with the scores on performances we've seen. And a 15.4 on beam from Swelu, and that is easily the best score today. And we shouldn't be surprised.
Certainly, and she's going to have some competition from her own teammates, but she will be in the final round and hunting for that gold medal.
And for Elisabeth Seitz, 15.166 uneven bars. That's third best of the day behind Beth Tweddle and Gabby Douglas.
And that was a tremendous skill she threw, a full twisting Ginger release move.
Senia Afanaseva will be the last Russian competitor on floor, but for Grishina, 14.066, there was a penalty of 0.2.
1/10 for stepping out of bounds on the first pass, and I believe the next 10th for being overtime or off the music, whichever.
Yao Jinan, Next on beam for China. In fact, the final competitor on this apparatus.
2011 World All-Around Bronze Medalist right here. China's top seed. Standing full, and she is off the beam. And that is one thing about China is they can completely hit and just sweep the competition, or they can start to implode. And we have seen that many times in competition. Right here, another major break. Those are huge deductions. Silver on balance beam at the 2011 World Championships, and she may not get the opportunity to defend that medal.
It's unlikely this score is going to count. They have Huang with 13.866, and then two very close to the top with Sui and Deng.
Double pike dismount. Finished up strong, but she knows she had some major breaks in there.
Well, that's a very disappointing start for Yao Jinan. Next time.
Here's her full twist. Watch her feet. Watch right here. Right foot just slips off the beam, and she is not able to keep the strength in that left leg and pull it back. See the tremendous pounding right there. And once you're off a little bit, see how skinny that beam is. Tough to stay on. And right now what she needs to be thinking about is not only keeping it up on those next three events for the team, but for the all-around as well.
So China has finished on the beam. We're just about through our first rotation, it seems. I think we're done on floor as well. Germany, 43.332. The total on uneven bars. Early team rankings don't mean too much. Until everyone's been on every apparatus, it's quite misleading, if anything. 12.833 for Yao, and they'll be discarding that one. Four perform, three scores count. Got the lucky mascot in the bag. 44.432 for China, the total on beam. Might be waiting for one last score to come in, perhaps, as reason for the gymnast not marching on to the next apparatus.
Victoria Komova sporting a new hairstyle, a no bangs look. I didn't recognize her at first.
I think bangs is a term almost unique to your country. I think we just call it a fringe. But I know what you mean. All right, on they go. Second rotation, Russia will be on the vault. Germany the beam. The floor it is for China in the mixed group on uneven bars. Kim Bui of Germany. Here's a look at her bars performance.
Sure. Germany hoping to break it into that top eight for the team final. Nice Stoops to a Ginger. Moving very quickly through this routine, very confident on these release moves. These transitions from high to low and low to high can give you trouble, but she is right on. Big dismount, full in. And Germany is doing a great job on this event.
And 10th best score on uneven bars, so Kim's not going to make the apparatus final, but a good solid performance to help the team there. On that left side of your picture, the massive bank of broadcasting positions. And again, don't read too much into these early standings after one rotation. Except to say that the United States moved to first place and really weren't shifted. They did have one wonderful session. Well, we learned that Jordan Weber not probably going to be in the all-around final. How would that rock the team, do you think, Shannon, for the USA?
It's devastating for Jordan, and to be able to pick herself up after that and still compete at the team final, it's going to be a test of strength and personal willpower.
And yet for other gymnasts, we were just looking at the Russian lineup as they prepare for vault. They take some heart from that because she's so respected.
Absolutely. I think every athlete knows what it feels like. I felt the crush of myself, the heartbreak for Jordan, but at the same time, you have to be excited for Allie Raisman and what she did, Gabby Douglas, for pulling through. And it's a strong team, and that's what they're here. They're focused on the team, so they've got to keep that in mind. But I certainly think some of the Russian girls, Victoria Komova, particularly for the all-around, she sees the door now wide open. We have heard rumors of the Russians training 2.5 twist in Yurchenkos. That's the Aminar that we keep talking about. U.S. put up 4 of those in a row, which gave them that huge starting score. And so we're going to see what Russia does here today. They may save them for the finals.
So Anastasia Grushina, first of all.
And that is a double twisting Yurchenko, a little low on the landing. 5.8 start value. Judges are watching your chest on the landing. How low is it? Is it hip level? Is it knee level? This block off the vaulting table doesn't quite get the block that she needs to get full rotation around, get that chest up a little bit more vertical, and she does step into that red area. Be 3/10 of a deduction.
Might have just tweaked the lower back there too, Anastasia.
Those landings, when they're low, they are tough on the body. Ankles, back, everything can hurt after that.
14-3-3-3 for Grushina. Not attempting a second vault, so won't be after the vault final.
And here we're going to see that Aminar vault, the Yurchenko 2.5. Victoria Komova hoping to defeat the Americans in the all-around. 2.5 twist, very well done. Beautiful vault, and that makes a huge statement right there. 6.5 in start value. This is going to be a big score.
So named after the Romanian, Simona Aminar.
This is right. 2000 Olympic champion, Simona Aminar. incredible that she was doing it at that time, and still today a very difficult vault. Gets that pop off, beautiful in the air, just a little bit of the twist of the feet, but this is such a high scoring vault. This is exactly what Komova needed to do today. Keep those legs nice and tight together. She's in, squeezing those arms in, looking for that landing. Blind landing, very difficult.
Do you think every time Simona sees someone do her vault, she says, "That's mine"?
Always nice to have a skill named after you, especially if more people actually compete the skill. You hear it often.
Jessica Lopez, Venezuela, and uneven bars.
Jim is working these pirouettes.
Second Olympics for Jessica.
Beautiful ginger inside the bars. The bars are wide, but still very difficult. And here she'll do her transition, high to low, low to high. Little bit of a break in that back. She's able to pull it out, double front dismount. Remains composed and saves that routine.
I'll spend some time in Colorado, University of Denver. Good program there.
Strong program. Collegiate programs in the U.S. for women. Very strong. And what a great surprise to be able to compete in the collegiate rounds and then come over to the Olympic Games and compete as well on your off season.
Sui Lu, I've seen a wonderful routine from her on beam.
Whipped a triple to open. Doing a good job of staying in bounds. China won 14 gymnastics medals at their home Olympics in Beijing. 9 of those gold. This is a new routine for Sui Lu, choreographed by renowned choreographer Adi Pop. Final pass, that standard double pike.
Well, Sui Lu, second at the World Championships on floor. Not too many deductions in there, Shannon.
Not too many. She did an excellent job, and it's great to see her out there having a good competition. You know, she had a major setback in 2008, not being selected for that team, and that's difficult to get over, but here she is doing a tremendous job. Whip direct to a triple twist, just that one step out, but overall fantastic routine.
Do you know the story behind her missing the Beijing Olympics? She would have been 16 at the time, just too young, just missing out.
Well, it's hard to say. With the makeup of the team, you have to have the right events at the right time.
Now Oksana Chuzovitna, representing Germany these days.
Oksana is always a fan favorite. pretty good on balance beam, but vault is where she absolutely shines. You will likely see her in the vault finals. Likely meddling in the vault finals. And I have to say, personally, I am just in awe that she continues to do gymnastics at all, much less continue to compete on several of the events, a few of the events.
Gold medalist, 1992, Barcelona. The team event.
We competed together. She's still out there. I'm in a chair. Oksana competed for the unified team in 1992, then Uzbekistan from 96. ...2004, and then on to Germany. Double tech dismount. Great job for Oksana. Good to see her out there. A few balance errors, balance checks. She's going to be looking for vault.
14.233 for Sui Lu on floor. She might not make the apparatus final on floor. Huang Qishuang.
Opening up. China's known for their beam and bars. Touch weaker on the floor exercise. Double tuck. We'll look for the D score. Once she is scored, that will help us understand what type of score she receives. Double pike dismount.
Well, memorable finish from Huang.
And it's great for her to be here. Many did not think she would make the team. She's somewhat inconsistent with her gymnastics. When she hits, she's great. But it's difficult to put someone on the team if you don't know they're going to hit every time.
She had a couple of top fives in the all-around at World Championship level.
And if she's on, she can really help China. This first tumbling pass, 2.5 twist. Punch to a Barani or a half twist. And right here, just a double tuck. And again, gymnasts are not allowed to lunge anymore on the landings like they used to back in the day. Now we're looking for those stuck landings. And of course, beautiful stretch, picture perfect in the air.
Lopez, uneven bar score, 14.266. And Oksana Chuzovitna on beam of 13.7. So the athletes getting ready to move on. One to come still on floor though. Score is in for Huang, 13-5-7-5. Just not their strongest discipline, is it?
Not a lot of high start values on that event, so even when they do hit their routine, it can be spectacular for that routine, but if it doesn't have a high D score, they're not going to get in the mid-14 range. Opening up with a triple twist. Girls working on performing, getting the audience involved. It's a lot easier to perform when you've got a little bit of the crowd on your side. Bit more powerful than her teammates, but that is going to be a fall. I don't think she fooled the judges by rolling out. You must show control of those landings. Finishing up with a double pike, again a little bit low, just looks like she's kind of running out of gas.
So the floor has just revealed a weakness across the Chinese team, although that said, she's had a fourth at World Championship level, Yao Jinan, but I don't think there was any disguising the fact that she had a major loss there.
She's just having a bit of a rough competition, but when you squat down on that landing, when you pass that 90 degree angle, when your seat's below your knees, it's very difficult to pull out.
Germany's first two totals are in, 82-6-6-5. They'd be desperate to make that eight-team final. They'll be right on the number, you think. There'll be a close competition. See if they can get through. Russian Federation certainly expected to feature. Yao Jinan looks like she might be carrying a slight leg injury as she limps towards the next apparatus.
There's certainly a couple of low landings. Mustafina on vault. Yurchenko double twist, opted for the double. Possibly the 2.5 twist during the team final, but that's all she needed for tonight.
So halfway through the competition for this group, subdivision 4 of the women's qualification, and they go on to their third apparatus now. With China to the vault, Russia uneven bars, mixed group has the beam, and of course Germany therefore the floor. China will be looking to pick up some valuable marks on the vault, but this is the floor for Yao Jinan.
China expected to be in that fourth position, and there's that squat. And again, here she just makes her breaks, decides to roll out, does not fool the judges. Nice cover up. It was a good thought.
Fair attempt at improvising, but there'll be no floor final for Yao Jinan. Team standings after a couple of rotations. I don't think we're going to see the United States moved.
Can certainly see the Russian Federation closing that gap, though. The couple of big vaults.
So it's China to the vault, Russian Federation, uneven bars, mixed group on the beam and the floor for Germany. So still warming up on vault.
China's not known for huge difficulty value on the vault, but they are closing in on their best event, the uneven bars.
He Qixin will be first on vault for China. ...20-year-old from Beijing.
Yurchenko full, not a great degree of difficulty, but she has been looking energetic in training, and she's coming up on her best event. The Olympic gold medalist on uneven bars in 2008. Many thought uneven bars might be the only event she competed for China, so just to see her out here vaulting is a great thing. Again, that Yurchenko full remains on the cream color part of the mat. She will not get a deduction.
She's also won a world championship on uneven bars. That was 3 years ago here in London, so good memories of the city. ...13.733 for He Qixin. Deng Linlin is next for China on vault.
And she will have a bit higher start value, typically competing a Yurchenko double twist. Big vault, well done, just that step. And of course, a deduction if she stepped on that red portion of the mat.
The Russian Federation, uneven bars. And Alia Mustafina.
Don't see a lot of smiles from Mustafina. She is all business today. Russia is so well known for just beautiful gymnastics. Beautiful turns, nice catch. You can hear her teammates cheering, helping her through this routine. finishing those pirouettes. Close to handstand. One and a half twist. Beautiful routine. Russia is bringing their A game for sure.
Well, she's had a silver medal at World Championships on uneven bars. Needs something in the high 14s.
Well, and if you want to find something good about a knee injury, it's that you get to work a lot of uneven bars. And that work has certainly paid off. Watch this dismount. Starts with a full end, but does an extra half at the end for that blind landing.
Deng Linlin, her vault, 14.833. And Wang, third up on vault for China.
I think Yurchenko, double twist. Much better on the landing. Looked right down the center. Good form in the air, and I think the biggest factor for China is the fact that they are not competing any of those Aminar vaults. None of those two and a half twisting Yurchenkos. That extra half twist gives you an opportunity for an extra 7/10 of start value.
Huang did win the vault at the Asian Games in Guangzhou 2 years ago.
And she has beautiful position in the air. Legs nice and tight. Little bit of a knee bend as she comes down for the landing, but it's so quick when the judges see it.
Mustafina, 15.7, second place on uneven bars.
Komova looking for that all-around title. Beautiful laid out Jaeger. Ever so slight split of the legs. Double-double dismount. Incredible height. She just hangs up there in the air. And this is absolutely incredible. Podium training didn't go all that fantastic for Russia, but they are really bringing it on here during the qualification round. Lights and cameras are on, so are they.
Just think we're likely to see a pair of Russian gymnasts in the uneven bars final. Mustafina looks safely in.
This is a great event for Komova. I would not be surprised to see her in the final round. She has added that pike to Kachev and the double-double dismount.
I'm just loving these super slow-mo cameras. It gives you a whole new appreciation of the work they're doing between the bars.
Incredible height. And she is so elegant and beautiful to watch. Perfect lines.
For Huang, 15 vault.
And that's a great score for that vault. Not much in execution deduction.
And Komova, 15.833. And she's just edged past her teammate Mustafina. Still both behind Beth Tweddle. But looks like there'll be two Russians in the bars final. There's a limit of two.
And that was Paseka. She is not competing the uneven bars, so she does what we call a scratch, and she simply salutes the judges, touches the bar, and salutes once more. More of a formality than anything else. There's another look at vault. And a devastating landing. Did not have enough power rotation to get around. She did hit her feet first, so she will get a score, but
this is Yao Jinan, isn't it?
She is having just a horrific competition.
Oh, nearly a face plant. Fortunately, she's upright, but pride wounded and a leg, I think. She's not having a good day.
And that is going to be very difficult for Team China. Of course, new life during the final round, so if they can get onto the qualification, if they can get through in the top eight, they have new life and a chance to put it together once again.
As these scores do not carry forward into other competitions.
Another look, just in case you missed it.
I think that's going to find itself on a highlight reel or two.
It is just painful to watch, and of course, that's what the mats are there for. Keep these athletes as safe as possible, but that one bites your ankles for sure.
Super slow-mo cameras, 3D cameras. It's just an absolute show for you at home and for us here. So vault score 43.566 for China.
A rough go of it for China on vault. Not the highest start value, but like I said, they're moving toward their best event. If they can put together a great bar round, they'll throw themselves back in the mix.
Good results on uneven bars for the Russian Federation.
You know, Russia is looking absolutely incredible this competition.
Not yet done with this third rotation. Still some action happening on floor and beam. Germany on floor. And they still have Elizabeth Seitz to perform there. A troubled session, I suppose we could say, for China. But Russia moving along far more smoothly and apparently injury-free, which is just as important.
Hopefully they'll be able to carry that over to the balance beam. It's been a little bit of an issue for a lot of teams throughout the day. A lot of falls on beam throughout the qualification.
Yeah, Gina, and your heart really goes out to her. She's had some problems.
You finally make it an Olympic team. You get to compete. And when you don't put it together like you do in training thousands of times over the years, it is heartbreaking.
So the Russian team having an informal meeting and waiting for this performance. Elizabeth Seitz of Germany, last competitor up on floor in this third rotation.
And it is fun to be the last competitor up on floor, particularly at an Olympic Games where the crowd's eyes are all on you, your opportunity to perform. Big opening, piked full in, struggling to stay in bounds. And that's going to be a close call. Very nice triple turn. And the crowd is getting into it now. Athletes packing so much tumbling into a minute 30. Double tuck, dismount.
Yeah. And again, a lovely finish from Elizabeth Seitz. And all these performances so important for Germany to just try and squeeze into seventh or eighth position and make the team final. Probably doesn't have the difficulty to claim a place in the apparatus final, but the team is the thing at the moment for Germany.
That's right. They have the opportunity to make it into that top eight. And she is struggling so hard, she knows not to put that first heel down. Right here. Fun look at the double pike from overhead. And again, this double tuck landing. Very well done. Looked like she had a lot of fun out there. See the strain on these twists. You've got to know exactly where your body is at all times, know where the floor is.
So, Seitz is on her way. The last rotation. And the German team will be on the vault runway. Russia to the beam. China, uneven bars. And the mixed group will be on floor. China will be hoping to really put together some good routines on uneven bars, make up some lost ground. 13-8 for Elizabeth Seitz on floor. Still US, Russian Federation, China holding on to third despite their problems.
Pardon me, looking at the point spread. Really only 3 points between U.S. and the Russian Federation, which is not much when you think about all of the errors adding up. Just a couple of falls, a few steps on the landings, and that's closing that gap really quickly.
That's where the teams will be for this fourth and final rotation for Subdivision 4. One more group of athletes to perform to complete qualifying for the women. Just reminding you, they're looking for a place in an all-around final, a place in an apparatus final, or if they're part of a team, part of the eight-team final. Can talk endlessly about where you think the beam should fit into your rotation to make best use of it. Russia have it last. But they've been performing so well, wouldn't expect anything catastrophic to happen here. And Alia Mustafina will be up first.
It's always good to have that positive momentum going into balance beam.
On the floor, representing Venezuela, Jessica Lopez.
seventh at the Worlds on beam.
Beautiful.
2010, sorry.
Beautiful double turn. Standing Arabian. If I were that balance beam, I'm not sure I'd want to give Mustafina much trouble. Unfortunately, she's having a couple of issues right here. Those breaks in connection are going to be deductions. Of course, the wobbles as well. She is such a fiery gymnast. Reminds me a bit of Svetlana Khorkina. Great Russian gymnast. Double tech, beautiful stuck landing. That's the way to finish it. And she stays on, obviously, a few breaks in there that you don't want to have, but will be a decent score.
Good scores on beam today have been in the high 14s, low 15s. Sui Lu, the best, with a 15-4. And speaking of the Chinese team, across to uneven bars, and Huang Qishuang.
She is absolutely spectacular on this event. When she hits, and that's going to be the big question here. Such incredible lines, full spin on one arm. Big release move, gets it done. You always know there's big skills coming up when the coach stays there to spot. Beautiful. And she puts it together tonight. Beautiful double layout to finish. That is going to be a big score.
Bronze medalist on bars at the Worlds last year in Tokyo. And really has to be considered for a medal here too. But boy, is there some competition.
You say Chinese wrote the book on balance beam. They did so on uneven bars as well. The angles they hit, the stretch, the technique, and the lines. When they hit, particularly the ones we're seeing today, Huang, Quixiang, absolutely unstoppable.
At the moment, on uneven bars, it's Great Britain, Russia, Russia, Tweddle, Komova, and Mustafina. I think China is about to play their hand. 14-7, Mustafina on beam.
Might get her in the finals. Not the score she was hoping for. She knows she can improve. And it is going to be a tremendous uneven bar final to watch, particularly with Beth Tweddle in there.
Well, Huang's 15.266. That's fifth best. Should just about see her through to the apparatus final.
That's right, and not where I expected her to be.
Now, he keys in.
And she is the defending Olympic champion on this event. So quick on these full spins. Sky high on these release moves, back to back.
Huge connection value for that.
The crowd is gasping. Another beautiful laid out Jaeger. She is just as impressive as ever. Stick straight handstands. Full twisting double back. Very well done.
Oh, I think we've got a new best. She tallied a 16.725 to win the gold in Beijing.
That camera angle was a little bit easier to see those lines, see whether or not she was hitting those handstands. Absolutely beautiful. So high. High enough to have plenty of time to grasp that bar in a mixed grip. Get ready for the second connection.
Now, here's a moment to look forward to with Chisovitna across on vault for Germany.
She is a wife, a mother, and many-time Olympic and world medalist on this event. Front handspring, front layout, 1.5. She is so powerful. That is a high scoring vault. Starts from a 6.3 in start value. And she will be going for a second vault here. Look at the power she gets, the distance on this vault. Just that step backwards and a little bit off to the right. But that will still be an extremely high scoring vault.
Come over on beam.
She has been looking so good today. She lost the all around. If you can call silver at the World Championships a loss, I don't know that you can, but lost that all around to Jordan Weber last year at the Tokyo Worlds by such a slim margin. She does not want a repeat. Beautiful Arabian, spot on. She has such a wonderful balletic style. Bit of a break. Arabian double front nails it. Absolutely wonderful.
Well, the dismount, one of the standout features of the whole routine. She probably won't have Jordan Weber to worry about in the all-around final as things stand at the moment.
That is correct. She's got two other USA athletes to worry about and a couple of others, but that was certainly a big turn of events. Komova doing her job tonight, and she did spectacular, but does still have room for improvement, just as the USA athletes do. A couple of small errors here, but just a delight to watch. She is so light on her feet. You can see right there, just a little bit of a break. Balance deduction, but look at that form. Gorgeous, just doesn't get any better. And here's her dismount. Perfect block up in the air and just knows exactly where she is on that landing.
And for he Kizin, that 15.966, she'll just slide in underneath Beth Tweddle in terms of the best scores today. And Chisovitna.
Big smiles for Komova, the Russian Federation. Great to see those smiles here at the Olympic Games. A lot of pressure here.
Kushina's already posted a 14.9. She's sitting in sixth position for the beam. But we'll leave those thoughts for a moment and go to Deng Lin Lin on uneven bars.
Some more beautiful lines. And this is a great routine, but after the spectacular performance we just saw, you can see some of the small errors here and there, legs apart. Again, that's being incredibly picky. Big dismount, full twisting, double layout. China ending on a very good note.
Already have two of the top four on uneven bars, but now Afanaseva on beam.
...2008 Olympian, and she really is the one on this team that has that mature attitude. Russians did not bring home a medal at all during the 2008 Olympics. They are certainly going to change that here, I have no doubt. Very nice connection. She was seventh on this event in 2008. Seems to be running out the clock a little bit. You can't end too early. Double tech dismount. And Russia has had a very good day.
And they've delighted their pocket of spectators here at the North Greenwich Arena.
The Russian Federation working so hard on this comeback, bringing back the beauty of gymnastics, their strength, their program, and they are doing a great job here in London.
As it stands, they've got a couple in finalist position for the beam. You're going to come over and Grishina. And a well-performed team seems to be a happy one. They haven't let themselves down today. Move into the team final, probably in second position.
And not by much. It is going to be a tight race, I think.
So come over, 15.266 on beam. And that's second best. Afanaseva, 15.066. And she's edged out Grishina, so it could be Afanaseva and Komova representing Russia in the beam final. But we've still got other athletes to come. We shouldn't count them in just yet. But the Russian total of 180.429 sees them supremely through to the team final. Just behind the United States, at 1.4 marks behind, and well clear of China. 14.166 for Deng Linlin on uneven bars. But you know, if China eliminate the problems they've had today, they could be much higher up the standings.
Well, and I tell you, Russia, if they add one more Aminar in there, if Mustafina puts it together, that closes that gap, could close it by 5 tenths. Then you're talking about a couple of errors, and they're right in there with Team USA.
And Oksana Chuzovitna is going to make the vault final.
So happy to see that. And in the third position, no less, I have no doubt she is going to medal on that event once again.
At the age of 37, outstanding. So the gymnasts are leaving the arena to conclude what is the fourth of five subdivisions. In the last group, there'd be Japan, Romania, and two mixed groups. Great Britain's had a good day. The women's team performing well. Well, the Chinese had a strong finish on uneven bars, but they left a few points out there. They can improve that come the team final.
China certainly has some room for improvement. And many times when they put it together, it is absolutely incredible. A sight to see. Russia did its job tonight, and I am excited to see who the top eight are going to be. Certainly we have a couple more great teams to come.
But certainly the United States, Russian Federation, China, and Great Britain, you can pop them in to the team final. Italy's going to get there too. What about 6, 7, and 8, though? Canada, Germany, and Australia will be put under some pressure by Japan and Romania. France and Brazil cannot make it. So still some important action to come on qualification day for women's artistic gymnastics here at the North Greenwich Arena. The end of the session, the spectators making their way out. Most of them will make their way home on the wonderful tube network that ferries people around the place in London, and it doesn't take you long to get used to it. It's a good way to get around the place. Well, even we've worked it out, Shannon. It gets us here and back.
That we have.
And that's the way you can fill these venues so quickly and efficiently and get people home again. And that about wraps it up for this session here, but more of women's qualifying to come, and we do hope you'll be able to join us again and enjoy it.